Feel my psycho power.
Now, face the mighty bison.
What up, everybody? It's Galactable here, and we're back here with Pop Culture Shock's new M. Bison statue. And we have Deadeye over here. Say hi.
Hi.
So, I thank everybody that came back to join us on this review, that has been watching the previous review. I appreciate that a lot. But today we have a piece that's actually very near to my heart. This is M. Bison from Street Fighter 2.
And Bison!
Yes. So this is M. Bison from Street Fighter 2 and made by Pop Culture Shock. This is the 143 out of 500. This is not the deluxe. There was two versions of this. There was actually three. There was this one, the basic collector's edition. There was the deluxe that had his psycho power coming out of his hands, which I'll put a picture of right here. And there was the black version. And I gotta say, the black version is sick, but I couldn't get my hands on this. So I got this for a screaming deal from a private collector. I hit him up. I was like, hey, what do you want? And he offered to me way below retail. He was just kind of like in a pinch. He wasn't super happy with the piece. And I was like, oh, I'll take it off your hands. So he threw the price out there. I paid him and he shipped it. And it was all good. It was awesome. I'm happy with the piece. That doesn't mean it's perfect. But we will get into the pros and cons of this piece very, very soon. Now, just a little backstory. Street Fighter and Street Fighter 2 was originally an arcade game, and M. Bison is the main protagonist, and he uses what is he calls his psycho power, which is kind of psychic abilities. As you guys can see, you have the elements of his psycho power on the base and all that, and in the picture that I showed previously of the deluxe edition, he has a psycho power coming out of his hands, which is really, really, really cool. I wish I had that, but I couldn't find one for retail. And I do gotta say, a lot of these are going below retail, so as soon as they pop up, they're sold already, because I mean, you're getting it below retail. That's the thing with Pop Culture Shock. It never holds its value unless it's certain pieces, like the quarter scale Sagat. I just bought the 1/3 scale Sagat by them. This is the exclusive edition. I don't know if you guys can see it, but I bought the exclusive part for my friend, and I'm getting the actual 1/3 collector's edition from Sideshow. So that should be here in 3 months to 2 months. I'm doing the payment plan, so expect the review coming real soon. And I think that piece is gonna hold its value and skyrocket. The PCS Goro from Mortal Kombat, the 1/3 scale one. So there's a couple pieces that maintain the value, and there's a lot of Pop Culture Shock pieces that do not. And it's a shame. I think they do great things, but their customer service is not the best. It's kind of the company just got sold off, and there's a whole thing going on with them, so they're kind of, The new owner of the company is dealing with a lot of stuff right now. But so
customer service being GameStop-esque, you're saying?
Yeah, kind of like real rude.
Like they don't give a shit.
My friends have had certain situations where they've asked for money back and they've had to fight for them over it, where it was a clear case that it was the company's fault or their QC fault or something like that.
Just like GameStop.
Exactly. So, all right, let's get into the piece. We'll start with the pose, then we'll get into the paint concept and actual execution of it. The pose, I think, is great. I think it displays M. Bison very strongly, and it gives off just that M. Bison aura. He is the man, he is the boss, he is ruthless, and he has no mercy, and it is, I like how, what would you say? I don't want to say skirt, but his kind of, I don't know.
Overcoat?
His little overcoat, yeah, is hanging and going with the pose. I really, really love it. And I love the positioning of his hands and everything like that. So I really, really think they knocked it out of the park with the posing. That's the main thing that drew me to this. And I do got to say, the sculpt, I think, is absolutely perfect for Bison. And the grinning is just, it's amazing. I absolutely love it. The paint is okay. It's not the best paint. It's flat. I wish there was a little bit more shadowing. The red was a perfect color. I actually really, really love Red Bison. I wish I could have gotten my hands on the black one because I just think that that one's more desirable. But I do love the Red Bison in the game. The boots are pretty plain. They have the guards and on them, but there's no really texture on this piece. I think that's where people kind of didn't like the piece. There's not too much texture on the clothing and the material and everything like that, and I do see why. But I really, really love the sculpting. You can see his muscles, you can see the muscle definition, and the physique is just amazing. The posing of the hands, the skin tone paint is really good. Over on the shoulder pads, the scrapes, they're good from afar, but when you get close, you can tell it's kind of just painted brush strokes on. It's not really, some is like deep cuts, but not all of them. So it was kind of cheap how they got away with that. The actual overcoat is actually pretty thick. And surprisingly, I thought this thing was gonna break in shipment, but this came perfect and I was really, really surprised. Now going back to the pose, I'm really worried. I love the pose, but I'm really worried on the ingenuity because it's only being held by one peg, one key, and I'm afraid of leaning issues. So over time, I'm afraid the statue is literally gonna lean, just like the Vega, the OG Vega does, and certain pieces like the Jade from Mortal Kombat, or, you know, there is leaning issues and leaning worries on that. So I don't know, I hope not, but it's a chance I took. It was a screaming deal, so I'm not really losing out. I'll get my enjoyment. I love the base. The base actually has texture. It's like a real psycho effect, and it just gives it its own aura. And the rest of the base actually, I really, really do like how it's kind of like mechanical. You can see like a purple orb in there, and it's done pretty relatively well. The design is well, the paint is good. And it's usually pop culture shock bases are just flat black bases. Lately they've been doing a lot more unique stuff and I appreciate it for what it is, so that's a step up. Usually you just literally get the flat black oval base and they call it a day with a little bit of designs on there. And it's good. I like that stuff because it doesn't take away from the piece. It just focuses on the piece, but at the same time, like I say, in certain things it would be nice to have something to add to the piece like this, because it is a real flat with no texture. I think this base, the base adds to that and it gives it a lot more. So I am really, really happy. For me, this is a keeper, but that's because I'm a Street Fighter lover. My friends introduced me to Street Fighter. I played it when I was a kid and all that, but recently my friends, for the past year or two, they've been really, really introducing me to Street Fighter a lot more. And I use Street Fighter from the anime. I didn't know it as the video game, like deep, and how there's this whole world and competitive world about it. It's amazing. And I really fell in love with that. They really taught me about the arcade side, especially my friend who builds arcades. And he's really, really into this. And my other friend, who I wheel and deal all the time, he's an amazing player. So it's really kind of ignited my love again from Street Fighter. Now that I loved it for the anime, now I love him for the video game even no more, and it's just awesome. Another thing that I really do love, and it comes with a light up feature, which I'm gonna flip on for you guys. I hope it should, boom, right there, does it show on camera? Does it come out real well?
Yeah.
Yes, no,
yeah, yeah.
Boom. I like how his lights light up, and the base, I think it's awesome. Really strong LEDs, it really shows, and the lighting that hits the statue in its own certain way just really gives off that psycho power. If you had the exclusive, his hands would light up as well, I believe.
You got the Michael Jackson thing going on right now, though. Not gonna lie. He's doing a moonwalk with purple light underneath him. He's either Prince or Michael Jackson.
I gotta ruin every piece of me. Son of a bitch.
It's what you pay me to do.
Son of a bitch. Okay, so we had the bro, we had the Schmeagle, now we got the Michael Jackson moonwalk.
Yeah. Michael Jackson Bison. What do you think the M stands for?
Michael Bison.
Michael Bison.
You know what? If you look at it from the side, If his head was tilted towards you?
Yeah.
Yeah. Fuck. Fuck. All right. But we got Michael Bison here, and where was I? I'm off track now.
You were talking about the light underneath them, his psycho powers, how it kind of
right.
gives him that.
I love how his eyes light up. Thank you. Thank you for reminding me. I love the how his eyes light up, and it really gives off the aura. Assembly was super easy. It's literally just the hands, the base, and the head. That's it. You literally put the body. Oh, and the overcoat. So you literally put the legs into the base, then you put the overcoat, then you put the rest of the body, the hands, and the head. Real easy. The head did not slide in too well, but that's because of the lighting feature has to plug into the really small pinhole, so the light, so the electricity can shoot through to the ice. So for me, it's gonna be. I'm gonna try to keep it unbiased, but obviously I'm biased because I love this piece. I love Street Fighter. I'm gonna give this piece a 7 out of 10.
Yes.
A lot of people will disagree with me, but this is, hey, my show. I don't give a f***. Sorry. He agrees with me, so we're all good. We're all good. 7 out of 10, that's what we're getting here. And I am happy, very, very, very happy to have them in display next to my Sagat, my Chun-Li, my Ryu. I just bought a Ken, and I have a Blanco over there, the B2 version, Play 2 version. So, is there anything you want to add to it there, Deadeye? What do you think about the piece other than you f***ing ruining everything?
Well, the flow of the overcoat, I think, is really good. It really kind of, like, granted, it's a flowing piece, but it really kind of shows, like, a clean look to the figure. Because you think about how Bison kind of presents himself, like, in the anime and also in the game, he always has these straight lines about him. Like, when he has his overcoat about him, you know, he's very, you know, he stands straight up, he's proper. It's a seamless, straight line sort of figure, and to kind of see him like this, you still kind of get that, but you have these eccentric motions about him. You know, the flowing of his coat, you know, his boots and his hands, you know, it sticks out a little bit, but it also kind of has that nice aesthetic straight line to it. So it's a very well sculpted piece, I think, because it kind of keeps that sort of presence that he has about him.
Donnie, Shadowloo for life, baby.
But we're not going to mention the 1982 film.
Dude, with Van Damme, that shit is awesome.
As you are, Colonel.
What a surprise. Welcome to the Shadowloo front. You're just in time for the kickoff.
I'm afraid not, Colonel. Security Council has just voted. They've decided to negotiate.
You're joking.
Everybody hates it, but it's cheesy as fuck. It is the worst movie, but that's what makes it the best movie. And if you don't know what I mean, just watch it. Did a f***ing chip on my base? No, it's just a sticker.
False alarm.
And that's where we're gonna end it, folks. Anything you wanna add there, dad?
No,
he's shaking his head. Well, folks, I'm not gonna tell you to subscribe and share, but you know what to do. Crush that f***ing like button. Peace.
Jump on.
Happy!